We'll see brute force technique and we'll try to see the problems. After that, we'll go to recurrence relation. So example, you have matrices M1, M2, M3, M4. Then how many different ways we can multiply them? Let's do brute force. In brute force, we try all possibilities. That means try to have this combination and find the cost. Try to have this combination M1 cross M2 cross M3 cross M4. So this is the way. That means we have to parenthesize the problem. See here. One here, first this one, after that this one, result. Then here, first this one, after that this one, after that. In that way, I'm parenthesizing. You know one thing, number of ways of parenthesizing four matrices, if you list out, you understand the problem. Third one is, you can do like this, M1 cross, maybe M2 cross M3. After that, whatever the result you get here, cross M4 you can do. After that, later we can multiply this one. So next one, it would be M1 cross M2 cross M3 cross M4. Let me write first. Then see, 2-2 separation done. So M2, M3 first focus. Then let's do like this. M1, M2 first. After that result with M3. Then after that M4. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Anything else? So there is one more way. M1 maybe. So rightmost. M2, M3, M4. M3, M4 first. After that result. After that this result. Okay. So if you see these things, then there are five ways we can multiply them actually. So this number is not easy one. It is exactly equal to Catalan number. The number of parenthesizations possible for this n matrices is 2ncn/n+1. So if I substitute n value, number of parentheses you are using, if you see how many sets, see one set, two sets, right? Everywhere. Yes. So using two sets, we are parenthesizing them. Then given two sets of parentheses, how many different ways you can write them? That is a question. So that parenthesization problem is actually Catalan number. What is that? Number of different ways you can parenthesize some expression is a Catalan number. That's value is 2ncn/n+1. So that is minimum 2^n. It's more than that. So that's why I would like to say that if I try to parenthesize your problem in all possible ways, for everything if I find out the cost, then I can solve the problem. Once I find out the cost, then I will find out the best cost, correct? But that parenthesization is taking 2^n time minimum. Then if n value 1000 or 100, then automatically the number of such combinations will become 2^100, minimum 2^100. And it is very large number already, I told you, correct? So it is more than number of atoms in the universe. That means it takes thousands of crores of years to just know which order is better. And let's come to our old problem. What is our problem? We have a computer, supercomputer. On that supercomputer, you want to multiply some matrices M1, M2, M3, Mn. You want best way. You want to decide which order you want to multiply the matrices. Correct? So, based on the order of matrices, you are going to get some benefit of cost. Correct? So, if I order them properly, you are going to reduce the cost of that overall multiplications. That, you know, the difference will be maybe example. So maybe for 500 multiplications, then maybe you can reduce it to 250 multiplications, and the difference absolutely in minutes. Okay, so you are going to save some minutes of your computer time when large number of matrices are multiplied. Okay, maybe hours. But to decide to save 1 hour of time, we have to give the best order. To give the best order, if you follow this brute force technique, that is going to decide which parenthesization is best. But to decide which parenthesization is best, one more program we have to run. That program is going to evaluate all possible combinations of orders, which takes 2^100 time for 100 matrices. That is going to be more than number of atoms in the universe. Otherwise, that is going to be billions of years or trillions of years. So after trillions of years, if you really follow this method, what happens? After billion years or trillion years, you are going to get the fact that which one is better, and you are going to save 1 hour of time. To save 1 hour of time, so we have to waste first 1 trillion years to know what is best algorithm. What is the best order, correct? That's why now this is not feasible. We don't use this method. So we are going to use a method that is dynamic programming method. So we are using that, we can compute the best order. That means we are going to decide the best order in order of n square or order of n cube time. We will see that.